on my snow. Looking for a better tomorrow, so they don't have to feel no more sorrow. But the law, they still fighting for the motherless children of war. But the law, they still dying, so we can't let them hurt us no more.
Can't let them hurt us.
But the law, now they still crying for the fatherless children of war.
Oh,
so if you're for the law, we still trying. We can be stronger than ever before.
Mothers fighting, children dying, mothers crying. It's a cycle, crime retired. And the eye for people die by the knife or the rifle, whether the Quran or the Bible. Yes, it's all just a title. Yes, we all are God's disciples. So hear me now. We have to wipe away the tears and the sorrow. We have to set it for the children of tomorrow. And even when every road gets narrow, we live in love, that's our way and our motto.
The children don't know the difference between right and wrong. We've been traveling down this road for far too long. Yes, I'm wailing that the truth straight through my lungs. And I want to take control of the human race. Why you standing on the podium lying to my face? We know what we're gonna chase you out our gates.
Good evening, viewers. Hope everybody's doing well. Happy Independence Day anniversary, 30th year anniversary, a very big milestone in Eritrean history. And today we have for you an artist for Eritrea, two guests. Well, one of them is not a guest. One of them is a regular contributor, Laini Tadesse. And we also have Moses. How do you say the last name, Moses?
My name is Moses Kusesira, and I'm the CEO of SMG.
He's our brother from East Africa, from Kenya to be exact. And we are very happy to have you here on our program. So we are going to talk about some of the new tech advances that have taken place in the industry as we have been inside for the last 2 years, almost 2 years because of COVID. There's also a lot of other advances that have taken place, and Moses is a brother from Kenya who's going to be able to explain to us some of the new ideas that we can bring to artists for Eritrea. So with that said, Moses, thank you for joining us. Tell us a little bit about your background, a little bit of history about you and who you are.
Sure, yeah. I came from Kenya about 20 years ago, came directly to Las Vegas, and got into the tech industry immediately. Back then I didn't even know what a microwave was, but I was able to, go to school, teach myself technology. I worked for UPS, Expedia, a few other point of sale companies. And in 2012, I decided to start my own company with a few other partners. And we went to Silicon Valley, started the company in Silicon Valley. And we've been running since then. And about 2 years ago, we decided to expand to Africa to basically provide our technology in Africa. And, COVID hit. And now our technology is needed more than anything in Africa. So we are focused solely in Africa right now, providing technology for people in Africa.
Well, that's a very huge undertaking. But I think with change is coming. A lot of Africans are also up to the speed in terms of technology now. So it's a perfect time. I don't know if you could say that. Is it the perfect time to make that transition and talk a little bit about why it's important right now?
Right. Yeah. Well, as we all know, the whole world got stopped by the COVID, virus, and the biggest problems that most people experienced, in the whole world, but mainly in Africa, was the businesses not being digitally transformed. The big problem is if you're not digitally transformed, then and you depend on the normal, typical, physical type of business way, you experienced a hardship, or some of them closed. We know a lot of businesses closed because, once COVID hit and transportation was stopped, and the whole thing, basically it stopped the economy as we know it. And so right now there's a need to have tools that can help people, number one, first of all, digitally transform their stores or services, and number two, be able to monetize these services and stores from online platforms. And so we built a few platforms to help with that.
That's interesting to know. And so with that said, Moses, talk a little bit about your products and what they can bring to any organization. I know you have three integrated products that are working almost parallel with one another. And so why are they important? And talk a little bit about them, if you don't mind.
Sure. So our first product that we came out with is an award-winning product that has been used all over in the United States with sport teams, in the NBA, NHL, to big, huge hotels and casinos. And that product is called Snapp, S-S-N-A-P-P. It's a marketing customer engagement product that has a very unique technology in the background to basically help monetize the normal marketing. So it goes beyond a like, it goes beyond a follow to create more engagement and basically monetize that engagement. So that was our first product that we came out with in 2012. And that product is still moving strong. It has won a few awards. And our next product is called PaySoko. That's the product that we just released for Africa. And that's PaySoko. Basically, Soko in Swahili means market. And so what PaySoko provides is the ability to do global e-commerce have the capability of taking any kind of payments from whatever you are. And the idea here is whether you're selling a service or you're selling a product, you're able to basically take any kind of payment from, whatever type of country that you're in. And on the other end, you get paid in whatever currency that you're using. So this product right now, it's deployed in Kenya, but we are planning to deploy it all over Africa, starting with East Africa, Eastern Africa, all the countries around Eastern Africa, moving to the West. And the idea there is to open up the global e-commerce market. So now you have access to a global market. And then our last product is called ShoFi. And this is built specifically for content providers, artists, and that kind of a thing. And the idea behind ShoFi is that it gives you the ability to basically do shows and be able to pay, have people pay for these shows. And these are online shows, you use your phone and be able to stream and record the shows. And then afterwards, save those shows or any type of content and be able to monetize that content. You're in control. With ShoFi, you basically own your content. And we are just providing a platform for you to monetize it. And so we bring the sponsors, or you bring the sponsors. Either way, the content provider makes more money than the platform. We are trying to change the aspect of how everything works right now, because on places like YouTube, it costs a lot. So most of the time people are not even making any money.
Right. So talk a little bit about, you can still keep your Shopify and still be connected to YouTube and all that stuff. I don't know.
Absolutely. We are not replacing YouTube. That's the number one thing I always want to make sure people know. We are working to, you know, in tangent with YouTube, but providing you the ability to monetize your content even further, right? So when you come to Shopify, you simply can pull all your content that you have on YouTube to Shopify in less than 5 seconds, right? And once you pull that content and now the content is on Shopify, you can basically start monetizing that content by basically charging sponsors, just the way YouTube will charge sponsors. The difference is you get most of the money. You basically are in control and get most of the money. Other than the way YouTube, you need 4,000 hours and thousands of views,
right.
Hundreds of thousands of views to start making money.
And that could come in handy for artists and entertainers, people who own a lot of content. So that's great. And so with that said, I want to go to Line A if I could. Line A, you know, based on what Moses has just said, how could Shopify be of help to you or any other artist? Can you talk a little bit about that?
Yeah. First and foremost, I just want to say thank you, Moses, for you know, being on this platform and giving us an insight on the new tech world. And what I would like to say to that is, I think it's incredibly amazing because it gives an artist or whatever that has content on YouTube a platform on a higher degree, like knowing that, hey, I can get my content on Shopify and still have my content on YouTube, but Shopify shows more value of my content. It's all about the value of your content being appreciated with the monetization and on getting your, what you said was you get more than YouTube, which it opens up the eyes of a lot of artists. I think it's going to be amazing. Just by you saying a few things that you just said right now, I'm already thinking about moving my content to Shopify because I'm an artist. I'm a reggae artist from Eritrea, world music. Right. And we're getting ready to celebrate our 30-year independence. So
obviously, you need no introduction, Line A, because you're part of Artists for Eritrea, and I'm happy to have you here as part of this 30-year anniversary. But with that said, Line A, also with Shopify and Payseco and Snap, you know, one of the things that we have done, and I'll go to Moses here. Moses, we have built a strategy to work with a global sports apparel network called Tie-Dye, which we'll talk a lot about. And so tell me the relationship that you, the partnership you've built with Tie-Dye, Moses. If Moses could chime in on that, if you could talk a little bit about what kind of relationship you have with Tie-Dye.
Yeah, absolutely. So with Tie-Dye, we built a relationship where we are integrating some of our systems into Tie-Dye. And also from a partnership standpoint, we are able to provide some services to Tie-Dye. So the number one integration is PaySoco, right? A payments system that basically can connect and let anybody anywhere in the world buy items from Tie-Dye. So right now we have, you know, credit cards, banks, PayPal, M-Pesa, which is the largest in East Africa, integrated into PaySoco. So that means somebody in East Africa can buy, you know, items from Tie-Dye right now and get them, you know, delivered into East Africa. But on top of that, you know, going back to the content providers, one of the biggest things that we try to make sure that people understand is you know, the social mediums nowadays, they became a huge conglomerates, and you know, for you to make any kind of money there is always tough because you need to have thousands of followers or thousands of likes. And one of the things that we focus on is the engagement. So we've integrated some of Shopify with PaySoco and Snap, and we've integrated it such that, you know, before the show, during the show, and after the show, or whatever content you're pushing, you can monetize. You can create not just the typical monetization, which is ads. You know, that's the typical way that most of these, you know, Facebook or YouTube work. But you go a little bit step beyond, you know, where you actually create gamified engagement, you know, where you can give out points, where you can give out offers and discounts. For example, work with a Subway down the street and offer discounts based on however many views. For every 1,000 views, you know, you get 100 points. If you hit 500 points, you get a discount to tie-dye, you know, things like that, where you collaborate with other brands and be able to monetize it just, you know, beyond the normal typical ad view, like go a step further. And also it helps you build a database. You know, you're building a customer database at that point. So you can always ping them and, you know, and sell them, you know, like, you know, tie-dye items, or if you have a tie-dye shop, you can always, you know, when you release new content, you can always push it to those customers.
Absolutely. And we'll talk about tie-dye to everybody. Just I wanted to give a little background on tie-dye. Stands for think it, do it. And it's an apparel industry, but it's also a movement of Africans, Caribbeans, people of color from around the world who are going to try and bring prosperity to our communities around the world. And I think that by doing this and integrating this technology into tie-dye, the sports movement, as well as the movement that the technology movement that Moses has created for us, we've also gotten Line involved. Line, actually, if you could talk a little bit about your e-commerce site on tie-dye.
This platform, tie-dye, it's an incredible platform. The reason is because I'm an artist, and it's given me a gateway to really, like, take my brand into a whole new level. Like, literally, like, I've been a brand ambassador pretty much for a very long time. I created my own brand. I've had my own, you know, t-shirts, hats, but now with tie-dye, it's taken it to a whole new level. It added more value, and it shows that, hey, I can have a piece of what is out there and get a piece of all my brand, all my merchandise professionally being, you know, out there, sourced out. So it's a great opportunity for a lot of artists that really have their own brand, that are focused. You got to have a brand. You got to create a brand. You can't be just an artist and just have no brand. You got to have something that shows of who you are, what you are about. So with that said, you know, create a brand and be, you know, just have something, a meaning behind your brand as well, not just anything. So tie-dye has really, you know, I can't wait. It's like the sky's the limit from what I have seen so far. So, and then with this, with Shofi and Moses, I mean, my brain is going like crazy right now. I'm thinking about a lot of things. So it's exciting.
Well, this is a great time. And we're bringing it to our Eritrean community on this special Independence Day anniversary, 30 years. It's time for economic prosperity in Eritrea. Mm-hmm. It's time for economic prosperity in Africa. It's time for economic prosperity for all people who've been lagging behind in terms of economically building some kind of wealth, you know, because we always say Black Lives Matter, but they have to matter in the pockets of people as well. And so with that said, I wanted to bring the whole idea of your store, which we built for you, a tie-dye, couple of weeks ago. I'm talking about a couple of weeks ago we built that thing for you, and I think so far you've been able to design. Talk a little bit about how you've come up with a song, one of your songs. You're able to design a t-shirt that resembles and sounds and talks about what you're doing. So talk a little bit about that experience.
Yeah, the content. The content, basically, I mean, I have a song. It's the title of the song is For the Love. So there's with the lyrics of my song, you're basically talking about the reality of where humanity should be, you know, for the love of unity, for the love of respect, for the love of Africa, you know, our home. And just in general, your content, it's gotta hit home before anything else. You have to have a content. And then with that, it follows with your brand. So with that said, I mean, the store just opened up not too long ago, and I'm getting a lot of people asking me questions like, how did you get that? Where did you get that? It's awesome, man. It's a good feeling.
Beautiful.
To have. Yeah,
it is beautiful. And Moses, if you could chime in. So tell me, why all of a sudden now are you trying to build this connection, you know, connecting all the three groups together? Was that something that came out of your thinking? Is it because it's integrated? Is it because, I mean, why are the three products important to being together integrated? Can you talk a little bit about that?
Well, yeah. So I've been in the hospitality space dealing with point of sales. So basically payments for a while. And also, you know, when Facebook and those things were coming out, I was the early adopter, and I used to tell people, hey, you need a Facebook account, and we'll have, you know, groups like HP laughing at us saying, why do we need a Facebook account? You know, but now everybody has to have one. So when we came out, we focused on the marketing part, and how do you really drive marketing or do marketing and see the ROI? You know, we understand, you know, this whole social media likes and those kind of things, but that doesn't bring money. You know, we really focused on can you calculate how much money you're spending on your marketing and how much money you're getting back, right? And that was the sole idea of starting Snap, you know, and putting Snap together. So as we built that, you know, you know, in 2018, when we decided to expand to Africa, and when we went to Africa and we got blown away on how Africa has leapfrogged, basically Africa leapfrogged the computer era, right, to mobile. You know, they went straight to mobile, right?
Yeah.
And so that in itself was mesmerizing, you know, to us. And we thought, hey, you know, number one, we know that we have talent in our continent, you know, not just from actually, you know, making items or goods, but, you know, from actually content creators. You know, we have talent, you know, nowadays the best music comes from Africa, you know, the African music has taken over and it's just getting started, right? And so you have, you know, people also who are great actors, you know, content from actually creating, you know, African type of movies. So when we saw that, we decided, you know, we have to build something that is built specifically, you know, for our people, you know, and that will give the ability for our people to actually make money and, you know, and to be in control of their content. But, you know, when we built this, we decided, you know, to not only just look at it from one angle. So instead of just building another YouTube, we wanted it to be interactive, right? So we built a system that kind of combines YouTube and Zoom, you know, but then adds on the marketing piece with Snap, where you can create engagement points and things like that, and then be able to collect payments, you know, in whatever currency. That's where all that tied in with each other.
That's brilliant. That's a brilliant way of doing things. African thinking. It's like, think it, do it, right? Tie-dye, right?
Yes,
think
it, exactly. Do it.
So what I wanted to say with, you know, as we wrap, and, you know, we're not going to be long, you know, Moses, talk a little bit about, you know, the company and how people can get involved. You know, I know that you've said that you've limited amount of opportunities for people to be able to get involved in terms of buying small shares and that kind of thing. So if people want to do that, can you talk a little bit about that and give the address and information or anything else you have to add so we can wrap it up while you're there?
Absolutely. Absolutely. So one of the things that you brought up, you said, you know, it's time for us to help our people create generational wealth. And, you know, one of the things we want to lead by example. So our company is a Silicon Valley company, and we fundraised close to $3 million from Silicon Valley type of investors and across America. And one of the biggest things that we know is that most of the people that have created wealth have created it by investing in startups, right? So if you think about like the people that invested in the PayPal they call them PayPal mafia, you know, all those people that were early investors or participated in the in starting up PayPal became wealthy, and then they started investing in other startups like Facebook, Square, and things like that. So until recent, just a couple months ago, you could not, as a normal person, you could not invest in a startup. You had to be an accredited investor, meaning that you have to have a net worth of at least $300,000 or $1 million in assets. So they made it hard for normal people to be able to invest in startups, because startups, even though they're high risk, they are high returns, you know, high returns. You know, if you can imagine, if you invested in Facebook earlier and you put, you know, a couple thousand dollars in Facebook, and then Facebook is now worth $1 trillion, you can do the multiplier, right? And a good example of that is, I'll give you an example of a company called Oculus that did a Kickstarter. And Kickstarter is a crowdfunding environment where people basically put in money and get the item. So this company did that, and people will buy these, their augmented glasses. And the augmented glasses went for like $500. So if I bought, like, you know, my nephews and my whole family, I would have spent $3,000. Well, 3 years later, that company, or 2 years later, that company sold to Facebook for $2 billion. Now, if I had put that $3,000 as part of the investment, I would have walked away with $250,000, right? But I just paid for some augmented, you know, glasses. And so we want to change that, you know, we are changing that. And so we've basically put our company on a platform called WeFunder. It's like the Robin Hood for startups. And we are offering basically anybody, everybody, the ability to invest. You know, this is a one-time thing only. We want to lead by actually showing that, you know, you as a group, we can provide people the ability to also be part of something big. And so if you go to wefunder.com/social media gateways with an S, again, that's wefunder.com/social media gateways, you're able to invest as little as $100 into a startup. And right now, our company is valued at $10 million. So you're getting it at the lowest, you know, you can get, on WeFunder, because by the end of the year, the value is going to go up. And if all those companies that people invest on Robinhood, they're already hundreds of millions, billion-dollar worth companies on Wall Street. Right now, this is a company that's just a startup, and we are offering it to, you know, our people. And we are leading by showing an example. You know, it's not always, if we say Black Lives Matter, let's make their pockets matter as well.
Absolutely. Thank you. And we're going to put up the address on the screen for everybody to see. I truly appreciate. Is there anything you want to add in terms of questions I haven't asked you? Because I truly opened my eyes with a lot of things today, Moses, and I wish you much success in what you're doing as an African. As Eritreans, we're very thankful that you've joined us in our 30 years of hard-won independence and hard-won safety, and Eritrea is doing well considering what it's been through. And so I want to say thank you again. If there's anything you want to add to your last words.
Yeah, I just I want to add on to what I was just saying right now as far as investment. I urge everybody to go invest in any company. It doesn't even have to be ours, right? Any company, you know, as a startup, right? That's how wealth is created. You know, not investing when the company is already a big company. Invest when the company is small, right? And at that time, it's high risk, but it's high rewards as well. And, you know, right now the government has passed the law that anybody can become an investor, which is democratizing the whole investment world. It's a huge thing. So I urge anybody and everybody to just, whatever company you think is best, try and invest in those companies. And I'm happy. Thank you so much for having me. I'm happy for you guys, and happy independence to all Eritreans out there. And, thanks for having me.
First and foremost, I just want to say thanks to you guys, Mike, for making this happen, Moses, and Dawit over there. And I just want to say, man, what you said, Moses, regarding like investing in, you know, startups, I never saw it in that way. And thank you for that, you know, opening that information at 411. And also the store that's in tie-dye, my address is tiedye.com/Lionel Tadese. tiedye.com/Lionel Tadese. You can go in there and get all your t-shirts, flannels, Eritrean flag, blankets, whatever. Everything is there that has to do with my brand. So it is our month. This month has been, you know, the month of Eritreans. May is the best month of the year because we celebrate our, you know, our independence every year. And this year is 30 days. And I want to say happy birthday, Eritrea. And thank you, Moses, for, you know, for all the information that you have dropped on us, like some serious jewels. And I can't wait to join this movement. Elevate, motivate. Let's go, everybody. Happy birthday.
Oh. Yeah, but I also want to add a couple of things here. Tie-dye is also mainly number one sports apparel industry. Obviously, that's what we're competing with, the likes of Nike, Under Armour, and other places. It's a start, and I think we're going to do well because already people are looking at this and saying, wow, this is good stuff. So with that said, on May 30th, which I want to advertise while I'm here, on Sunday, May 30th, this Eritrean Scandinavian Sports Association are going to have a festival, and I will be mediating that, and we're going to be doing a like 5-minute presentation on tie-dye so people understand what tie-dye is. Well, it's a movement, it's an apparel company, but it's also all this that we talked about today. And so with that, I want to say thank you to everybody. Thank you for joining us. Happy Independence Day. Viva Eritrea, viva Africa, viva peace in the world. Thank you.
Okay, thank one you. More thing. I want to give a shout out to Artists for Eritrea as well. Artists for Eritrea. Yeah.
Absolutely. Artists for Eritrea is hosting this. Let's not forget that. Artists for Eritrea, we have close to 200-300 artists that are part of this. We also have a huge worldwide audience that's going to be watching this. We want to make Artists for Eritrea movement, and Artists for Eritrea hopefully will soon be a part of the tie-dye movement. We're talking to Artists for Eritrea. So with that said, Laine, again, thank you. Moses, appreciate it. Good luck to you guys. Have a good day.
You too.
Thank you.
You must know, looking for a better tomorrow, so they don't have to feel no more sorrow. For the law, they still fighting for the motherless children of war. For the law, they still dying, so we can't let them hurt us no more. Children dying, mothers crying, it's a cycle. Crime rates higher than the eye. For people die by the knife or the rifle, whether the Quran or the Bible. Yes, it's all the subtitle. Yes, we all are God's disciples. So hear me now. We have to wipe away the tears and the sorrow. We have to set it for the children of tomorrow. And even when every road gets narrow, we live in love, that's our way and our motto. The children don't know the difference between right and wrong. We've been traveling down this road for far too long. Yes, I'm willing that the truth straight through my life.
lockdowns and them want to take control of the human race. Why you standing on the podium lying to my face? We know what we're gonna chase you out our gates.